Previously on Life is Strange.
Whoa. What did you find?
Rachel in the dark room. Over and over. That's it.
We can't trust anybody except each other.
You know more about her than me.
No. You and Chloe think you know more than anybody. Like all teenagers.
Oh, look. The Wonder Twins.
What are you doing in my dorm? You are so fucking dead!
Nathan is truly psychotic. I know he has something to do with Rachel missing.
Kate wasn't the first. All those binders are filled with other victims.
What are you doing here, Max?
Victoria has to be next.
What a lame gimmick.
Rachel, why is he putting her in the ground like that? Where?
The junkyard.
Max, we have to find that spot now.
Nathan just texted me. He says there won't be any evidence left after he's done.
Oh God, Max, look. She's still there.
Oh, no. Chloe. Look how.
What the fuck? For this, Jefferson. I promised I would never go back in time like this again. But this is the only way.
Thank you. great. Oh, Max.
This angle highlights your purity, see? The slightly unconscious model is often the most open and honest. No vanity or posing, just pure expression. Oh, Christ. Look at that perfect face. Hold that air there! Stay still! My shot! But please don't worry. We have all the time in the world. For now, I knew you were special the second I saw your first selfie. Yes, I still hate that word. But I love the purity of your own image. Not like Rachel, who was always looking in the wrong places. Poor Rachel. Let me try this angle. Don't move! Oh. Much better. Thanks, Max. If only Nathan could see this setup. He tried so hard. But you can't just throw a few subjects around and expect a cohesive style or theme. But he had an eye for shadows, and an eye for a whole lot more, as his elite family will find out, along with Arcadia Bay. Nice. Good. Oh, those eyes. It's just too bad you're so goddamn nosy, Max. But this room is under 24/7 surveillance, so all I had to do was text you from Nathan's phone, and you fell right into my hands. You really should have focused on schoolwork, not private detecting with your little friend.
Chloe.
Chloe, right. Hey, I'm sorry that I killed, that Nathan killed her in self-defense. But she had a troubled history like most Arcadia Bay dropouts. Nobody will be surprised or care. Though I promise, people will care when you die tonight, Max. I wasn't lying when I said you have a gift. Okay. Now this looks good. Maybe a few more close-ups. Mac, please do not move so much. I need you posed and framed my way. Maybe a new dose will calm you down.
No.
Now don't move or this will hurt much. Stupid! Bitch! You just don't listen, do you? In fact, you never did hear much in my class. If you had, you might have seen all this coming. God damn, you are a fighter, though. I've had my eye on you, and I've noticed that you've been more fearless this week than maybe your whole life.
No.
Remember my number one rule. Always take the shot.
Oh. He drugged me for his fucked up binders. Just to take photos. I'd really like to smash that fancy camera into Jefferson's face. Wait, Jefferson couldn't handle stains on his photos. Good, now I can use them. Okay, I broke those vials when I kicked the trolley. No, that picture isn't going to help. And I can't go through all that again. I won't. Like Kate and me. Do you remember how you got here?
No, I don't know. Wait, you warned me. You warned me about Nathan. Then I went to Jefferson for help and he was acting so weird. That's the last thing I remember. And I can't move my hands. Help me, Max. Please, I'm sorry for everything.
Listen carefully. Mark Jefferson kidnapped us. He's using Nathan as well. Jefferson is very dangerous, so we have to get out of here before he comes back.
Max, I just can't believe this is real. I don't want to die like this. I'm only 18.
Victoria. Please listen. I have a plan.
Really? How? Max, I'm so scared.
So am I. But we don't have time to be scared. We have to fight back. Now.
Max, I can't even move my arms. How are we supposed to fight?
I'm not going to let that asshole get away with this. I need you to be strong. I can't do this alone. We need to act while we're clear-headed. If he doses us again, we'll forget everything.
I'm not strong, Max. Look at me. Look what I did to Kate Marsh. Now she's in the hospital, and I'm here.
Kate wants us to get the hell out of here, and then we can both go see her again. Okay?
I'd do anything to see Kate once more. Just to tell her I'm sorry.
Victoria, we will find a way to escape. I promise.
Max, I believe you. You have to help us.
Whoa. I'm definitely more awake in this photo. I could try this one. This might work. Please work.
I'm getting some spectacular images here, Max. Yes, Victoria would kill to be in your place, but she doesn't understand our connection. You're the winner, Max. I choose you, your portrait.
Fuck you.
You're trying too hard. I know you're scared. You all have the same doe-eyed look when you wake up here, replaced by fear as you realize what's about to happen.
Mr. Jefferson, why are you doing this?
Oh, Max, I'm so glad you asked that question. Simply put, I'm obsessed with the idea of capturing that moment innocence evolves into corruption. That shift from black to white to gray and beyond. Most models are cynical. They lose that naivete. However, some Blackwell students carry their hope and optimism with them like an aura. And those lucky few become my models. My subjects.
Yes. You're a psychopath. And this is your last session.
Au contraire, Max. I'm so sane that nobody knows what's happening to you right now. As you can see, Sleeping Beauty here is too harsh for my gentle lens. And don't get me started on your late partner. I had enough of those faux punk sluts in my Seattle days.
You killed Chloe. You murdered my best friend.
She had a loaded weapon. This was clearly self-defense, but that's what happens when you play with guns. Or try to fuck with me. It's better when they don't know. Like pure, sweet Kate.
Kate believed, and she survived. You failed to break her. She's stronger than ever, and she'll outlive you.
She'll certainly outlive you. Who knows? Maybe I'll pay Kate a visit soon and test her faith again.
You will not get away with this. I want you to know that.
When you told the principal that I made Kate cry, I thought you almost had me. It's good our esteemed Principal Wells is like most administrators, a closet drunk. I do know that the Prescotts are going to have a major scandal when the town finds out what their elite son has been doing for homework.
You used Nathan.
I prefer the term manipulated. Like with an image. Nathan's was easy to twist around. I became a sort of father figure for Nathan. It happens often in teacher-student relationships. It was kind of touching for a while.
Did you tell him everything about your plans at Blackwell?
Don't be stupid, Max. I told him what he needed to hear. In return, I had access to the Prescott fortune. Who do you think paid for this glorious darkroom and equipment? How else could I get all these hip new drugs for my subjects?
Rachel Amber was your victim, not your subject.
Oh. Rachel Amber. That's the real tragedy. Nathan thought he could be an artist like me. Instead, the dumbass gave her an overdose.
Chloe and Rachel. You killed both of them.
They're fucking together in heaven right now. Is that what you want to hear?
Why? Why?
Why? Why? Start listening to me, you dumb cunt. I'm sorry, Max. That was not cool. Anyway, Rachel is dead. But no tears. Los Angeles would have killed her anyway, so look at this as a favor.
You're evil.
Oh, I see. You and your friends almost beat Nathan to death. See, we're not so different.
Yes, yes, we are. I cared more about Nathan than you did.
No, you didn't. It's just too bad that he fell in lust with Rachel. He actually thought he could mimic what I do with the camera and subject, like father, but not like son.
Where is Nathan now?
Dead and buried. After what he did to Rachel, I knew I couldn't keep him as a protege for much longer. Now the police will never find his body. Do you finally get it now, Max? I can't compromise my vision with amateurs.
You are an amateur. Look at the trail of death you left behind. You can't blame all this on Nathan. I don't care what you do to me. You're gonna die, motherfucker. For Chloe and Rachel and everybody else.
I do love your spirit, Max, but you brought yourself here by your own choice. Anyway, I like my models to be seen and not heard. So I have to make sure there's nothing left behind of you. Okay. Now, let's see how these shots came out. I can see why your instant camera is so appealing. You don't need a computer to print your work out.
Alone with a heart.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Jefferson.
Max, I would love to talk shop, but I really need to go over these pictures, especially while they're fresh in my mind. I think our session was a career high for me.
You still have my diary.
Don't worry. Nobody's going to read it. Thanks for reminding me.
There's nothing more innocent than a teenager's diary. Oh, look at your selfies. What a waste of talent. Look at that shot, Max. You can do so much better. I could frame any one of you in a dark corner and capture you in a moment of desperation. Shh. I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word
I'm
for
back.
A wonderful photographic tradition.
Right back where I started this insane week. And nobody
course,
is going to hurt Chloe
know,
ever
the
again.
The portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
Daguerrean process.
Oh. Well, that was easy, Max.
Was it? Okay.
Well, okay then. So, the Daguerrean process made portraiture hugely popular, mainly because it gave the subjects clear, defined features. You can learn more when you actually finish reading the assigned chapters. Obviously, Max has read them.
And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday
time
Heroes.
To change time.
The winter to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the
first,
art
world. Let's make it real easy to capture Mark Jefferson.
Melissa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Bastard. I have to warn David about Jefferson and the dark room.
Even if you're submitting your photo for the competition, everybody in class is.
I should be able to track down David's number from the school pamphlet. Found you.
You see the dilemma?
I don't know, Mr. Jefferson.
I just worked so hard in the shop, and I'm sure you know what it's like to be...
For once, David, I'm praying you'll overreact to this as much as everything else. You wanted me to enter the contest, asshole. So maybe I'll be going to San Francisco. And Jefferson, you'll be going to prison. The past within the past. Am I pushing myself too hard? It doesn't matter what happens to me. I have to. I'm happy to fix it, so you'll be here to get your fancy camera, Victoria. Oh, Rachel. I'm sorry. Hi, Kate.
Oh, hey, Max.
Kate, listen to me.
I am.
Always remember that you're not alone. I've got your back no matter what happens. So do a lot of other people. We all care. We all care. We're all here for you. You need to know that.
Max, that makes me feel so blessed for the first time this week. I don't know what to say.
That's okay. Neither do I. Maybe we could both use a hug.
Thanks. You always know the right thing to do.
Ms. Jefferson?
I can see and talk to Mr. Donald.
Yes, I see. But me.
And why not?
Hold on, Dory. You okay, Max?
I'll be Victoria behind a screen, posting as cruel and unfair. You're to know how easy it is to hurt somebody, to destroy their life. I just want you to think about how much hurt if somebody did that to you. You can always make the right choice, Victoria. I know we've got a good heart. I've seen it.
Listen, I didn't
explain. There's no reason for you to be so insecure that you can't be happy with your own talent. Wouldn't it be better to lift people up than don't? You could inspire people.
Okay, I don't know what you're talking about now, do I, Mr. Jefferson?
I think you should stay after this one, Victoria.
Then I guess I'm done talking.
And that's okay, too.
That was kind of random, Max. What did you mean?
Here's my photograph for the Everyday Heroes contest.
Oh, that was easy.
No, it wasn't easy at all.
Well, I can't read, but I'm very happy you decided to enter. That means to me. And Blackwell, the fab for any artist is to put themselves in the world without fear. To be in it. Thanks for and maybe both of us will be heading to San Francisco this Friday.
Or maybe only one of us will be going.
Don't be so modest, Max. Can we?
You'll find out, Mr. Jefferson.